Oh, hello everyone, it's Susie Crypto Granny here. The date's the 18th of February and it's about, about 4:15 Amsterdam time in the Netherlands. Market cap today is 1.59 trillion, volume is 76 billion, which is a lot. Liquidity is 3 billion, which is heaps. And Bitcoin dominance has come down to 60.88%. Yesterday was around 61.9. Now, I do believe Bitcoin is going to get to 54215 as a minimum. And if it breaks through that level, it's off to the races to 60 or 70,000. I think Ethereum is limited to 2,200. I don't like Ethereum at all. They need to go to proof of stake. They're becoming very, very expensive and just not sustainable. Now, Binance, as I said, Binance Smart Chain is in direct competition with Ethereum, and I've had my investors buying Binance well before $100, even below that, around 35 or 40, something like that. I do believe Binance can get to 360 or more, and maybe even get to the lofty heights of Ethereum, because seriously, Binance is making a fortune. Now, to give you an idea, Coinbase, which is on the secondary market for tech, obviously is trading at $303. The issue went to $200 for the private high net worth investor and the institutions, and it went to retail at $277. So Binance is a much bigger concern than Coinbase, with about 52 million clients, and Coinbase about 44 million clients. So I'm very, very bullish Binance. And a lot of our investment cryptos have traded very well in our investment portfolio. Look, we just see more and more people coming into this crypto space. Google Ventures have backed blockchain and they're looking to raise $120 million. And I mentioned yesterday BlackRock are in there. BlackRock are a fund manager, a money manager, and those guys have about 8.3 million assets under management, which is actually huge. And they're even thinking about getting into Bitcoin as well, okay? So it's a great strategy. We know that, MicroStrategy has been buying more crypto, using debt to do that. Bitwise launches a DeFi crypto index fund, which is interesting in itself. More players are coming into this market every day, and it's quite amazing. Now, what we're seeing in Nigeria is the Bitcoin premium trading at 32,000 to where Bitcoin is at the moment. Bitcoin's just gone through 52,000. And that premium, for a Nigerian to buy Bitcoin, it costs 71,000 odd. And the reason why that is because the Nigerian their currency, their fiat currency is going down, 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 and there's a big premium for Bitcoin. Now, we could see that when the US dollar starts breaking, 103.80, okay? The US dollar currently is 105.83, but it looks very, very weak to me with all this corporate debt and everything else and, you know, trillions of dollars being issued in terms of the market, with their stimulus program. It just means the US dollar is going to go down, down, down. Now, if we look at the global debt levels in 2008, because of the collapse of the financial markets, global debt now is higher than it was in 2008, which is just unbelievable, okay? And, you know, it looks like every country in the world is increasing their debt because of COVID and everything else, which is not a great story. Cosmos Stargate is going to be updated soon. Also, Cardano, Mary, Hard Fork is going live on the 1st of March, and that'll be great for Cardano, okay? So, we've got Cardano in the top five, DOT is six, XRP is now number seven and being pushed out, unfortunately. Now, XRP, Ripple do have their pre-trial in February the 22nd, pre-trial conference. I don't know where that's going to lead, but I'm really sorry to say, guys and girls, I think it's going to take a while for this whole thing to be settled with Ripple. The next trial looks like it's going to be on the 16th of August 21. So what I'm pretty much saying to my clients is hold the existing XRP you've got, but, you know, build a proper investment portfolio, and that's what I do for my clients, to get the advantage of things like Binance, which is going up by 35% a day, okay, and other coins that I believe have the revenue and the client base and are going to last, in the next 2 to 5 years, okay, and that's pretty much what I'm looking at. Now, there's 8,000, crypto coins and tokens, and 97% of them are going to be dead. That is a fact in the years to come, and we don't want to be in those, because we look at everything. I look at everything in terms of crypto fundamentals and the technology, okay? Now, Mainframe apparently rebranded itself as HiFi, Fixed Rate Lending Protocol, which is interesting. Also, we had, there was someone else, and what was it called? Matic called themselves Polygon, which the trading on Polygon's been pretty interesting, got up to about 65 cents. It went whoosh straight up and then it came straight down. So it's pumped and dumped by the looks of it. There's always so much going on in this crypto market. It never ceases to amaze me. MasterCard and joined with Bahamas for their digital currency. They call it Sand Dollar National Digital Currency, and they're providing them with a credit card, prepaid credit card. Chinese Postal Savings Bank has created a biometric hardware wallet for digital yuan payments. So China intends to go digital regardless of what the rest of the world's doing. And it just seems to me that the US is way behind the curve when it comes to cryptocurrency. China already has released digital renminbi, or yuan as it's called. And, you know, they have a lot of people already using it, which is pretty amazing, okay? The Swedish bank said they won't go digital with the krona until 2020. Goldman Sachs, JBM, JP Morgan and UBS are trading an EFT tied to DOT, okay? An exchange trade product which has exposure to Polkadot, which is awesome in itself, right? So everyone's starting to get interested in crypto, and this is going to get bigger and bigger and bigger. And as I said, market cap will be about 4.25 trillion by the end of the year. I am very ultra bullish specific crypto. Okay, crypto that I've looked at and analyzed, and I'm very happy with the technology. Has a lot of clients and makes money, because all these coins and tokens have an underlying project which should be treated like a business, okay? Where the network makes money, they're doing a lot of transactions, they have a lot of people on the network spending their money, and, you know, the business is making money and they have clients and they get revenue, okay? Now, the US charges three North Korean hackers over crypto attacks, and apparently they stole more than 100 mil. But, you know, the North Korean hackers under Lazard's corporation, they call themselves, you know, they've stolen a lot last year. Apparently 5 billion in stolen crypto was stolen in 2020. So please be careful, everyone, because you need to have your crypto on separate wallets. Okay, if you have 100,000, you should technically speaking have 10 wallets, because if you make a mistake, you only want to lose 10,000 rather than 100,000. You know, there's been so many cases where people have lost all their crypto, 16 million of it, they had it on one wallet. So please buy yourself a Secure X wallet. They're very good. They're very easy, much easier than the Ledger. Seriously, it's really, really easy. So apparently in Texas, and I've been told by my Texan clients that the banks are closed. There's cold storms. They had snow there, amazingly, so even though it's desert. There was blackouts and everything. The wind turbines stopped running and the electricity's been off and people are freezing and you can't get any money out of the bank. So, you know, in that situation, you'd say that it's a good time for crypto for sure. They've had rolling blackouts in big sections, which is just terrible for the poor people that are freezing to death in Texas, which doesn't make sense. It must be global warming for sure. Just nuts what we're seeing there. Now, in the equity markets, I'm actually selling the Dow at the moment and the NASDAQ because, according to me, my charts have rolled over. It looks quite like it's going to come down a bit. So there will be risk aversion in the equity market. You can see that just by the trading. Also, inflation is in the system. Don't believe the Fed. Inflation is here. The price of food is up 36% per annum. Grains are going through the roof. We're starting to see oil go through the roof because of the Texas disruption. Copper's through the roof. Silver's starting to rise, okay? The only thing that's not rising, which has got me miffed and puzzled, is gold, which is at 1780-ish. So I don't quite understand that. But interestingly enough, all other commodities are going up, particularly food, soft commodities. Okay, so interesting in that. Now, interest rates are starting to rise. So keep on an eye on the US 10-year bond rate. It's at 1.29%. It has risen quite a lot from the lows of 0.52 in August of last year. So, you know, interest rates are rising, and certainly in Australia, the 10-year bond's gone to 1.39, and in the US, it's 1.29. So that's very interesting. But what's going to be out today is Philly Fed confidence indicators and business indicators, housing starts, and Fed Brainard speaks as well about the economy. But I can tell you something right now. You know, the Fed is being seen as the buyer of last resort and lender and borrower. But, you know, the reality is the debt problem in the US is massive. It's getting worse. And that's going to be very bad for the US dollar. The US dollar falls below 103.64. Keep an eye on the chart. It's going to go through 100 to the yen. And if that's the case and it heads down towards 77, Bitcoin will be at $150,000 per unit, okay? So, you know, again, we saw people buying exchange coins last night, Huobi coin, Oakby, Binance, and also Qcoin. I think that's the place to be too. It smells of an institutional buyer to me, for sure. So overall, I'm very bullish this market, but it's very specific cryptocurrency that has the fundamentals and the technology. Now, just looking at some of the news on Luna Crush, it's got Nevada unveils new processor chip built specifically for Ethereum mining. That's all we need. Bitcoin may become a better asset, says longtime gold bull Jeffrey Gundlach, who has his own investment fund, something like $141 billion. He's saying also Bitcoin might be a great asset for the stimulus. Also, there's a story here, Gates Foundation to use Ripple Interledger tech in mobile payments, mobile payments. Now, this is really big if this is the case, because it actually says that Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation released new open source software for the Unbank that utilizes Ripple's technology developed by the distributed ledger startup Ripple. I mean, this is huge, honestly. So the Gates Foundation are using Ripple's technology, which is wonderful. Also, Mass Kaiser unveils massive Bitcoin price addiction, says US dollar, you know, is going down, but there's a hyperinflationary story going on. And I tend to believe that. Inflation's in the air. When we look at the alts that did really well and what the social media is talking about, Binance Coin is number one, Frontier, Bancor, Swipe. We had Swipe, Elrond, Polymath, Venus, Ravencoin, Polygon, previously Matrix, Matic and Phantom, which is awesome. And also, if we look at our trading story, we've got a lot of signals that are very bullish, ultra bullish compared to bearish. And the signals that are bullish are 465 against 206. And when we look at our screener, the 10 out of 10s are all the ones that you'd think, right? Bitcoin, Ethereum, ADA, Binance, Litecoin, BCH, XRP's 8 out of 10, Link's 10 out of 10, all the ones you'd expect. Adams, 10 out of 10. Tron's, 10 out of 10. Theta, Vet, Neo. Neo's 9 out of 10. But it's pretty much everything we've got in our investment portfolio. All the exchange coins are 10 out of 10, as I said. And, you know, we're in the right place, which is fantastic, okay? Absolutely fantastic. Now, if we look at the volume last night, just the trading volume on Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Tether, Tether did 22.66 billion, Bitcoin 8.83, Ethereum did 5.71 billion, and Binance did 4.83 billion, which is huge. Litecoin did 1.3 billion. Cardano did 1.22 billion. So people are buying more and more. There's more money coming into this market. And that's, you can actually see that from basically the amount of volume that's been done, which is just awesome in itself. And also, if you look at wide world searches, we do find that, you know, even people were looking at Binance on that. Binance Coin, they were looking at Frontier, and they were looking at Frax Share, and they were looking at Pancake Swap, which is a DeFi. So, look, there's a hell of a lot going on at the moment. And I have to say, the crypto market looks very good to me. And you know, you've got to stick with the, you know, the really, really good stories in terms of, you know, whether they have a profit, whether they're making money and profitability, okay? So, you know, it's just all good. Things look very good. Also, there's Tron price addiction that Tron could get easily to 7. I've got a fair value on Tron, at least 11 or 12 cents, which is a rate of return of about 300%, okay? So it's all happening. Thanks very much, everyone, and I'll talk to you tomorrow. Thank you.